Hi, today we are going to do the 60th stotra. Bhagavan Bhagahanandi Vanamali Halayudaha Adityo Jyotiraditya Sahishnur Gadisattamaha. Bhagavan means the power who has the six great glories. One, the wealth. Two, the power. Three, the dharma. Four, the fame. Five, the character. Six, the knowledge. And seven, the dispassion. So, Bhagavan is only power who has all these six glories. Wealth. Wealth doesn't mean that we have the property or the money. The wealth means what we have in our mind, the dharma. Second one is the power. Power doesn't mean that we have the voice to control others. It means the power to stay on the path of dharma when whatever happens. And third one is dharma, is the path which is considered to be the rules of human, of how we have to live. The fame. Fame is something that we cannot get. It comes by itself. Fame means someone who is trying to follow you. And five, the character. Character means one who has something that influences others. And sixth one is the knowledge. Knowledge means something or information, data or details about something that you know. And seven is the dispassion. Passion is something you want to gain for yourself. But dispassion is something you don't think too much for yourself. And also, the Bhagavan knows the origin of everything. Dissolution, when it will happen. And the bondage and salvation of creatures, how the creatures are bonded together and when will they have the moksha. The knowledge as well as the ignorance, everything is known only by Bhagavan. Bhagaha. Bhagaha means one who destroys all the six glories that we explained now at the time of dissolution. For example, it starts with the Bhagavan himself. At the time of dissolution, he is destroying everything. So it can also be said like the positive or the negative things, like the beginning and end. Both are known by Bhagavan. Arrival and departure of beings. When the soul will be born to this body or when he will have the moksha. Vidya, avidya. When is the time the body can have the knowledge as the intellect strong, and when the body is weak with the knowledge or intellect, that is weakness. Anandi. Anandi means one who has the power to bless with anandam. Anandam means the ultimate bliss. And the divine bliss that can be given only by Bhagavan. And that will be permanent happiness. He is also called Nandi because he is the son of Nandagopa at the time of Krishna avataram, where he has been born to Yashoda and Nandagopal. He was there with them for few years, giving delight to everybody. That is, the devotees, when they wish for the happiness, Bhagavan is there to give them anandam. That's why he is called Anandi. And he can only give to them the anandam or the permanent happiness only if they have, they are pure surrender to Bhagavan and share the divine nature, the bliss. Vanamali. Bhagavan wears the floral wreath that is called Vanamala, and the name is called Vaijayanti, and it consists of five elements that is called Bhuta Tanmatras, and he wears it around his neck. That's why he is called Vanamali. Halayuda. Halayuda means, Ayuda means weapon. Hala means the plow share. That is the weapon we used for plowing. So Balaraman, the eighth incarnation of Bhagavan, has that weapon. That's why he is called Halayuda. Even now, for the successful cultivation and profitable harvest, the farmers will pray to Bhagavan Balarama at the time of plowing. Aditya. Aditya means the Bhagavan who has taken the Vamana avataram has been born to Aditi Devi and Kashyapa Maharshi. That's why he is called Aditya. Jyotir Aditya. Jyotir Aditya means Bhagavan is there in the brilliance of sun's orb. Or it is said that Bhagavan is the Atman. Atman means the soul. Soul of the glorious light and energy which is residing in the disk of sun. That's why he is called Jyotir Aditya. Jyotir means the glory of light and heat. And Aditya means the sun which gives us the life. Sahishnu means Bhagavan can have the contraries like the heat and cold, beginning and end, arrival and departure, Vidya and Avidya. So he can have all the contraries. Every pairs of opposites can be endured by Bhagavan, but he could not be influenced by anything, both physical and mental. That's why he is called Sahishnu. He can have all the opposites and he can endure it. Sahishnu means, Sahi means like you can endure. Gadi Sattama. Gadi means the goal or path. They say that everybody has only one Gadi, that is the Vaikuntha. And who has the resort or the support for everybody? And who is considered to be the greatest of all the beings, that is Bhagavan. But only you have to reach there through the noblest path, or the path of truth, or the path of dharma. And there you will have the essence of spiritual liberation. And the ultimate refugee for all the devotee is Bhagavan Sannidhi. That is Gadi Sattama. Sattama means the good, or Sattvika beings is called Sattama. Gadi Sattama means the ultimate target for all the Sattvika beings is Bhagavan. So here we are seeing the names Bhagavan, Bhagaha, Anandi, Vanamali, Halayuda, Aditya, Jyotir Aditya, Sahishnu, Gadi Sattama. So we'll be reaching the 566th name of Bhagavan. Bhagavan Bhagahanandi Vanamali Halayudaga Adityo Jyotiraditya Sahishnur Gadi Sattama.